Hey everyone, James Wilson here with BikeJames.com, and today I wanted to share some thoughts on a recent study that you're probably going to be hearing more about in the coming days that looked at e-bikes versus regular bikes and basically the fitness that you gain from them, because one of the knocks on e-bikes is that it's just this easier thing, and so you know you don't have the fitness to ride in the first place, and so you need this bike to do it, and you're not really getting the same benefits from it, and so it's not really the same thing. And the study looked at and found that that may not necessarily be true, that when you look at the, you know, statistically, the difference between an e-bike ride and a ride on a regular bike, that the differences may not be that big, but there are differences there, right? So the problem is we've got two different camps here who are trying to take extreme positions on this. You know, you've got one, the anti-e-bike crowd, which thinks that they're the, you know, reincarnation of the devil and one of the seven signs of the apocalypse and all this stuff. And then you've got the other side, which is that e-bikes are awesome. Everyone should be on an e-bike. They're the best thing to happen to cycling since, well, two wheels, right? And so, you know, obviously somewhere in the middle is where the best view is going to lie. But this study, again, can be taken out of context by both camps. But the e-bike crowd is going to point to it and say, look, you know, there's not that big of a difference. So you can't say that fitness gains from an e-bike ride are not the same. But that's not actually true, right? Because there were differences. Now, what they did is they had, I forget how many riders it was, but they went on a 6 mile ride, one group on e-bikes and one on regular bikes. And what they found was, like I said, statistically, they were very similar, but the differences were there, and those differences will add up, right? So for example, the heart rate of the e-bike ride versus the regular ride was about like 93.7%, I think was the number. So, you know, that's pretty good. Your heart rate, and so which is a good indicator of how many calories you're burning, you know, is very similar. You're burning, you know, 93% is much. But again, like that counts, right? Like that 6 to 7% counts. The other thing that they found was that the e-bike riders averaged 4 miles an hour faster during the ride. So they're actually finishing the ride sooner. So not only are they burning fewer calories because their heart rate is almost the same, but not quite the same, they're actually riding faster. And so they're not riding for as long. So they have a lower, you know, caloric expenditure for less time compared to a regular mountain bike ride. And again, over time, this is gonna add up, right? Like a little bit on one ride may not be statistically significant, but you look at those differences over the course of year or years, and it's gonna add up and it's gonna make a difference. So again, what the take home message from this is, well, one, when you hear about studies like this, make sure you go check out the studies themselves, right? Because you, looking at least the summary of the study will help you see, like, is the conclusion, is what the media telling me the truth? Because you'd be surprised how many times you'll go and look at a study and then you'll be like, wait a minute, where did they get this conclusion? Like, why did they write this article saying that this is what this is saying when that's not necessarily what it's saying? And so again, like, make sure you check out the source, and two, just keep an open mind with this. Remember, there's gonna be two camps wherever you're reading this from. If it's from the e-bike crowd, they're gonna be, look, e-bikes are great. You're burning just as many calories for the most part. It's just the same as a regular mountain bike ride, right? But the truth is, you know, and this isn't necessarily something for the anti-e-bike crowd, but they can say this, is that, well, those differences, while not statistically significant for one ride, they are there, and they're gonna add up over the long run. So you are missing out on some fitness. You are not getting the same benefits from an e-bike as you are a mountain bike. So, you know, again, they can continue to battle it out, but I think coming out somewhere in the middle is the thing. I mean, like most things, personally, and you know, I need to do a video on just kind of my thoughts on e-bikes in general, but I think that there is a middle ground, right? I think that if you're gonna ride an e-bike, that you should still ride a regular bike, because it's kind of like clipless pedals versus flat pedals, that the e-bike is gonna let you get away with some things that aren't necessarily like the best, most efficient way to ride your bike, because you have the pedal assist. And so your bike is gonna force you to do those things properly, build that fitness better in those areas. And so again, I think if you're gonna use them, you know, using them both, because they both have their advantages. I mean, you know, going on like a long ride with a lot of climbing, you know, having that extra, so you're, you know, motor there, so you're not putting out so much energy on the climbs that you can't enjoy the downhill. I mean, man, there's an argument for that, right? But using an e-bike to go on a 45-minute, hour-long ride, like, you know, I don't know, there's no excuse for that either, right? So somewhere in the middle, I think, is where we should come out. But anyways, I'll do another video on that. But some fuel for thought on the study, because again, you're going to be hearing more about this in the coming days. And I think, again, it's just one of the first studies that you're going to be hearing about, trying to compare e-bikes to regular bikes to try to justify one camp's argument over the other. But again, keep an open mind. Like everything else, look into it for yourself. Don't take my word for it, right? Go check it out for yourself and see if you come to the same conclusions. But anyways, hopefully you guys have enjoyed this tip, and I'll talk to everybody next time.